Early on in my career, I had the opportunity to do my first shipyard project. I really liked working with an aggressive marine environment with really big structures and big moving components and mechanisms and things that created jobs and really helped the economy. I've been in love with marine engineering ever since. My name's Matthew McCarty. We're here in the New York City office today. I'm a principal in our Ports and Maritimes group. I really can't understate the importance of ports. Our ports are in waterfront environments and they're industrial environments. And that means that they're subject to corrosion, to degradation, to storm damage, and everything up front or upland, it's a heavy industrial facility. Huge pieces of machinery are running everywhere, causes a huge amount of wear and tear to pavements and to other pieces of upland infrastructure. Working with our port clients, yes, they have marine engineering needs, but only maybe a third of a port's infrastructure is on the water from the bulkhead out. Two-thirds, everything else, electrical, stormwater, permitting, bridges, ports have bridges, they have it all, and they need help planning that and funding it and designing it and implementing it. And here at Stantec, we have an awesome team and global expertise that we're able to combine them and deliver these very multifaceted projects. Really looking at helping ports with their infrastructure more holistically. And since we as a country have really done a lot to clean up our waterways and revitalize our urban environments, more people than ever want to live, want to work, want to recreate, and they need to be that much more mindful on their environmental results of what they're doing, as well as light, noise pollution, truck traffic. And a lot of our ports, some of them predate the United States of America, built very low to the water for easy movement of goods from old ships. And now that we have increased risks of storm surge, of flooding, and sea level rise on top of that, we really have to rethink the way our port and marine terminal infrastructure is located and planned. One of the strategies for adaptation, for accommodating that future sea level rise that we like to employ, is called adaptable infrastructure. That infrastructure you're building to meet your demands of today, yet it can be improved, it can be adapted in a smart and reasonable way in the future to accommodate higher seas. One of the teams that I love to work with is based out of Montreal. They're supporting the Port of Montreal with their electrification program right now, with electrifying their rubber tire gantry cranes, the remainder of their ship-to-shore cranes, and they're wonderful to work with. And Stantec has given me that experience. I think civil infrastructure in general and port infrastructure, it's nice that it's very tangible and the things that we work on are generally around for a long time and we can show our children, we can show our family a very direct result of our labor in Kingstown and in Montserrat. These are the primary ports of these island nations. If we're 70%, 69% of our goods coming into and out of the U.S., for these Caribbean nations, it's 99%. Everything is coming in and out. Allowing these larger ships and more efficient handling of goods is really transformative for these nations.